Hello, my name is JD Share, and this is interview for Dash Fight. It's been actually not that good because basically the time difference is like 6 hours from Korea, and then so right now it's like what time is it right now here? 11 p.m. here, right? But the Korea is like 5 a.m. already. So I feel already sleepy, and then also actually the tournament starts pretty late, which is 9 p.m. So I kind of been to going sleep late, you know, to get used to this time zone, like 9 p.m., 10 p.m., 11 a.m. And then so I'm here having interview and then watching others day one. But the I think that I feel kind of I should go sleep early kind of, and then yeah, I need to try to, you know, to get used to this time zone. I really miss the offline event. So first of all, I'm really excited to be here and then to compete and then to meet all the players from the world. So during COVID, it's not easy to travel, right? And also the Korean government, Korean the COVID policy is not really. It's actually tough that if I get back home like Korea, then I have to do like 2 weeks self quarantine in Korea. But so I was thinking about it. Or should I come for offline event, or maybe should I say no this time? But I miss the offline so much, so I'm here. Yeah, I think it's more exciting. It's much more exciting, and then also much more motivation. Much more like hype. So even though I play, there's an online tournament in Korea these days, the things I just mentioned, I feel much better being in the offline event. This kind of production, like the boxing and the media interview, everything, this is just amazing because I play, you know, game, but. You know, I do like stuff, boxing, media, exhibition, like this, like a real, you know, like a real pro games. This is kind of, literally this is also amazing. This is amazing. I mean, the people from here, like, for example, they take care of us, the staff here. They pick up us at the airport, and then, you know, during COVID situation, it's not easy for us. I mean, being foreigner here, it's not easy for us like to get info about Ukraine or food or whatever. So they just take care of everything, you know. And then also we can practice each other whenever we want. There is an amazing practice room at the hotel we stay. And then this venue is amazing. And the media interview and boxing stuff. Yeah, the production, again, amazing. I was just a normal kid who likes, you know, games, like arcade game, PC game. I grew up with Tekken, and then also a lot of games, for example, like StarCraft 1, more like PC games. I traveled, even like I was like, my first offline ever in Korea was like when I was like 14 or 15 years old. I went to like offline meeting with my friends. Everybody was like, these like big brothers. I was nervous, and then yeah, I really loved Tekken, and then, you know, meeting people. So my brother, I have like 3 years older. He's like 3 years older than me. So I was like 8, and then he just take me to the arcade, and then during that time, King of Fighter was really popular. So we kind of played like a lot King of Fighters. And then like I was in middle school or something, and he was like, so all of a sudden he was like, hey, you have to play this game. And that was Tekken Tag 1. I was like, what is this game? And he was like, hey, this game is like better than King of Fighter. And then Tekken Tag 1 also was getting really popular, you know? So, sure, I'm gonna try that. And then I picked Jin, I picked Paul. We do like wah wah, and then that's how I started Tekken with my brother. Yeah, my parents, Korean parents are kind of, you know, they wanna do they wanna give a good education, like good job, you know, like stable job, right? But my parents actually didn't care that much, I think. Yeah, my parents didn't care that much. And then they even didn't know that I was playing games until I won the big tournament, like global tournament. And then, yeah, they also don't care. I'm pretty sure, even though I did, you know, if I hadn't played like Tekken, they wouldn't be like care about much about me. I don't think, yeah. They are like, so they are just like, you know, parents that, you know, who let you do yourself, but do all right, you know. Do your things all right. That's what they do. You know, back during the time, like back in like maybe 20 years ago, 15 years ago, arcade was somewhere, you know, where, you know, the, how do I say, you know, how do I say, kind of, yeah. Yeah, kind of, you know, the area was like, you know, the vibe, the atmosphere was really not bright. And then, how do I say in English? I forgot. You know, like real life, like they punch, not punch, but talk shit, and then, yeah, something like that. That happens a lot. Arcade happen a lot. Bullying, yes, yeah, right.
So how did you?
There was nothing I could do actually, because I was young, and then they are much older, and the bullying. I was also like being like nice to them, maybe, yeah. But this is pretty, like, nothing special, to be honest. The bullying culture at arcade, it happened a lot. Oh, yeah, that's true. Actually, so my brother, he quit, I just told you, you know, he quit Tekken. But my brother's friends at arcade, they protected me. Oh, the pandemic. Pandemic, you know, because of pandemic, I kind of stopped traveling, right? So I've been spending much time mostly with my family. So I feel like this is kind of great because before like pandemic, I was traveling too much, so I didn't care much about my family. We didn't talk that much, but pandemic, I stay a lot in Korea. Then kind of we get even more closer, you know, and then also my family got a puppy as well lately, and then yeah, I mean pandemic is kind of tough for everybody of course, but my family has been doing all right I guess. So 순돌 means like very old Korean, okay, but sounds cute. Like 순돌 순 means like be quiet, be nice. 돌 means like be smart, okay? 순돌. And I wanted to give him like a old name because in Korea the puppy dog gets like old name, I guess that means that the dog lives long, okay? So my friends came up with this idea, and then I like the name 순돌. So I named him 순돌. Yeah. I always wanted to have a dog, right? But I also didn't want to have a dog because I travel a lot. But I guess my parents, especially my mom, was getting kind of older, and then she was like, she's the one who wanted to have the dog. I was like half and half, but it's her decision. Yeah, if you take care of a puppy, then pretty, yes, sure. But I'm the one who take care of of him a lot, like most. I think, of course, I become more responsible. He's still young. He's now like only 1 year, and then. Yeah, of course, he bothers me like when I train, when I practice. I guess that's funny. Yeah, and then because of the puppy, my family, we talk more, right? Talk more, we hang out more, and then the puppy give us like good vibe at home. Yeah, I miss my puppy. Yeah. So pandemic, you know, so no travel means that. I got time to create something, some content, right? So I think I kind of like the creating videos, making, editing videos, and then I wanted to give you like, you know, any content, including like tips to people. So that's also probably I needed something I can focus on, you know, during pandemic. Even like, you know, game playing is good, but sometimes I put it, you know, kind of here, and then I want to focus something else. That is making videos, like giving tips, and then YouTube, stream. Yeah, they've been fun, and then there are more like content that I want to create. But I kind of need like more, I would say, set up something for, you know, and yeah, I mean, I wanted to just provide something fun but also meaningful to people. So I didn't think about this actually, but like a few years ago, one of my friends, he just came up to me with this topic very randomly. He was like, "Hey JD, what? And then you should write a book about Tekken. You should write." I was like, "What?" And then, because he said that, because there is something, there should be something that you only know, I only know, right? That's kind of inspired me. And then actually, I tried to write some like, you know, kind of, I drew like mind map actually online from like Tekken, this topic. I was kind of, you know, I also came up with the idea, maybe then, you know, that's also one reason I started YouTube, you know, stuff. Yeah, maybe something, that's probably one of my legacy, maybe. And then I'm pretty sure that's something I can give back to people, and then also something people will enjoy, yeah. To be honest, I consider like every time since I got 30. So I'm like 32, 33. I think about it like every time, even when I travel right now, yes. There is always like this portion, because I have to accept that I'm kind of old, right? Like offline event, I used to be always like young player at any event. But look at this event, I'm probably like one of the oldest one here, right? That makes me realize, oh, I'm old, and then they are young. And then, yeah, and then also reaction or like, I can, you know, the level of like, my ability of like focusing is not like before, probably. Yeah, like short, I think. And then when I was young, I had like less responsibility, right? I was only playing games, but now family, puppy, and more. So, and then, yeah, I guess this is natural, yeah. Ah, this question is so nice. I thought about it, like, I'm kind of afraid of losing motivation. That's, and then I won EVO 2017. Probably that's the best moment, best experience, best emotion of my life that I know I'm not gonna get again. Never, probably, because EVO 2017, I won EVO. It's great, but I also with a great team, great people, Echo Fox. I mean, everything was really fun. Everything was really like kind of new, yeah. And then right now, feeling of competing doesn't feel like before. This is what kind of make me scared, you know. But at the same time, I won big tournament, like Korean grand final in Korea, like last year, last moment. Like, that was like biggest one. I won that one. Oh, and then I kind of feel, you know, again, oh, wow. Like, motivation. Wow, I won. Wow. So I try to keep this emotion, yes.
All these people
yeah, around. Yeah, yeah. That's why I decided to come here, and then I played offline with the players, and then it's totally different. Wow, wow. I want to play more. Yeah. So I wake up like in the morning, and then I take Sundol out, you know, walk my puppy, and then I go to gym, and then from gym I start like stream. And after streaming, I do maybe more like off-stream practice, or maybe watch videos, or maybe I create videos, something about Tekken. Or maybe someday, maybe I just hang out with friends. But this is my usual schedule. Oh, and then I walk my puppy again, like twice a day. Breakfast, I prefer like something like a cereal or bread. Yeah, they are more light, you know, more than the rice. Actually, I was preparing Pakum Nam, like only Pakum Nam. I've been playing only Pakum Nam lately. And then I won also a big tournament last year with Pakum Nam. But like 2 weeks before this tournament, Pakum Nam got nerfed. And that's when I realized, Wow, then what should I do for Ukraine tournament? Like, they just nerfed my main character. But so I was thinking like, you know, thinking other options, you know, maybe change character, maybe, you know. But I have had like only 2 weeks from nerf moment to right now. So it's not enough time to change my main. Yeah, but my preparation has been Pakum Nam. But I'm sad for enough. everyone is really strong. I mean, they got even like stronger, you know. Especially European players, they have improved a lot. Wow, yeah. Pakistan players, of course, they are strong. But I'm surprised that European players, because they are not like before. They are literally strong. I feel pressure, you know. I mean, they study my style, and then also they want to be, you know, from the question, they want to be like me. Oh, that's still pressure. I'm just a player, you know what I'm saying? That's so much pressure. And then, yeah. And then, it's something different from the question. But I realized that everybody have every player, every region have a different way of practicing. In Korea, for example, has been only online. Online play has been like during pandemic. But I can tell the other countries, they've been still playing PS4 or, you know, PS4, which is a tournament format here. I think that it makes huge difference each other. I think Korean culture is very competitive, I think, including games. And then we used to have a great arcade culture until like a few years ago. And then that's when everybody got kind of level up each other. That culture made us very strong. But at the same time, there is no more offline arcade culture in Korea. I'm pretty worried about this, because international tournament, they always have a, you know, offline format, right? With a PlayStation 4 setup. But these setups are quite rare in Korea. You know what I'm saying? Korea culture is more like right now, PC and online tournament. And then I've been practicing with that as well. And then I come here. And then I have to reconsider how I should practice, actually. Because PC and PlayStation 4, they are very different, you know. And then here I again play PS4 in like, you know, during in like 2 years, big event. It doesn't look easy, actually, yeah. Yeah, I was, yeah.
What was it like to play back then?
Oh, back then, I was a student, you know. And then the game was like my hobby, but I really liked it because I traveled the world literally because of game, right? But still was like, there was, as you say, there was no big money, no sponsors, no teams. I just had fun with friends traveling the world. I never thought Tekken would be like this. Never, never. Yeah, yeah. But pretty sure that's the Tekken 7 FR Season 1. I think Tekken Season 1 FR balance, I'm just thinking right now, you know. Thinking back, I think Season 1 balance is better than right now Season 4, I think. But after Season 1, we get more like 2D characters. Like, who is first 2D character? Like, Geese. We already had Akuma, but we get more 2D, like Geese, Eliza, and then the new characters, they always come really strong, like Geese was strong, and then also Lidoi, Bakumram. So balance has been something more, I would say, more like sensitive. Yeah, and then still these days, right now, I don't think we see many characters at tournament. I mean, as many as before. I wanna make it more crazy, more 2D, more 2D characters, more key, more easier, more risky. This is what I don't want as a player, but as a CEO, they should make it easier, and then they should you know, make a profit with the game. So more stuff, maybe key system, maybe like key, you know, like normal 2D games. Maybe let's say maybe like Street Fighter, they have key, something like that. All else, I think definitely they should add a tutorial in the game. There's no proper tutorial in the game. So this game has one problem that has been kind of long, that new players they get always, you know, they struggle learning the game. Yeah, I always appreciate people like my game, you know. Even when I win, but even when I lose, people say, people still, you know, people see my game as like, you know, great moment. I just appreciate it. And then I think about the match, then I should have played better, of course. I don't know, because I feel like I have to play well, you know, because I didn't feel this way like a few years ago. I kind of feel lately that I have to play well, because I feel like there are more people watching and supporting me. So, and then the production event, you know, you see this kind of stage, amazing, but wow, nervous, yeah. There are a lot, yeah. There are new strategy I have to learn, and even I'm aware of, but I still, you know, strategy I have to beat. I can see that in the games. That's the first one, that you know, this is something I have to challenge. And then second thing is that Tekken has been getting like patch more often than before. That makes the patch makes character tier always like move up, move down. Some character goes this, goes up, right? So this one, because of this one, I feel like this is quite sad to tell, but I feel like I have to always study top tier characters. Because I don't think this game is balanced. That's first reason. The second reason is that everyone from the world, they are really good. And the tournament format is short. First two usually. So we need a better like easy situation, you know, for in tournament, like to win. In order to win, so maybe let's say one character, he get better, like, better, maybe let's say he can make a situation, maybe he can take advantage, like easier than your opponent, or maybe some character has a 50-50 mix-up that strong player have to guess, something like that. Something like this. Everyone is good. Tournament is short, and then tier list, there is obviously tier list in the game. So, and then there has been a patch very often, like twice a year. So we have quite, I don't like it, but I really don't like it, but everyone has to kind of top tier characters right now. I think, to be honest, Tekken has become big only from 2017. Before 2017, there is no official league, there is no like sponsors, there is no Tekken World Tour, you know. So before 2017, as I just mentioned in other question, I never considered Tekken like a pro gaming. So I stopped like many times that especially Tekken 7. Most of my friends, they all quit because, like, you know, they want to study. They get old, and then I was like, also, okay, sure, then it's less fun. And then also Tekken 7 arcade culture is not arcade culture actually, because Tekken 7 is online basically, even at arcade. So you go to arcade, but you don't play somebody at arcade. You do play like random person from different arcade, different city. This is also less interesting. So I think that's why I stopped. I think I'm kind of lazy, you know? And then that's first one, that first one. And then also I like playing offline. I really like playing offline, but Korea is mostly online. So, and then it's not easy to meet, is to, you know, meet like good players, I would say. So I don't enjoy playing online. But, you know, Korea has no offline right now, so I guess it makes me kind of play less. But watching tournament or playing in tournament, I get also motivation. So, like taking shower or walking on the street, and I suddenly think about the game. Oh, he does that. This character, blah, 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 blah. Yeah? Yeah. And then also, playing, you know, play the game matters. So I should play more probably, yeah. I think 2017 JDCL is much better. I think for that, in terms of playing performance. But I was young, I think. And then right now, I have the kind of fire talking with the others, you know, not like playing online alone. So actually, sometimes I coach people because they ask me, hey, like, they message me, like, randomly, hey, I want to learn from you. And sometimes I do. I coach, like, through a Discord. Yeah. And then, that's funny. I mean, also, talking to others is really fun. And also, it's a huge motivation for me. Yeah, and then also, also this is something different, but the reason I like passed in JDCL, I mean, when I was like, you know, having much more motivation inspired is that during the time I was with always like somebody, you know, my team, my sponsors. So they take care of me always, you know, and then, yeah. So event to event, they have been always helpful, you know, they always support me. And then, you know, yeah, that's it. I mean, it's always better to be with the people, yeah. To be honest, I think of no one. I mean, everyone is still, everyone, the world know, they are, you know, they are already known, and then they are already old, like 30-something. Ulsan was like 20-something, but he went to army lately. But other than Ulsan, young player, but to be honest, I don't think there is young, talented player in Korea. Because as a young player, they have either a struggle or have no reason to learn Tekken. You know what I'm saying? So it's not because there's no arcade, you know? Like, let's say you play PC game, PC, then what game would you prefer? Like big games, like big PC game, like, you know, League or maybe FPS. But Tekken is still very small. And then Tekken has always offline. Used to have offline, and that makes young student want to play. And then we kind of teach them at arcade. Yeah, there's no this culture right now. So I'm also not sure. I'm not sure if they want to play Tekken right now. I mean, young gamers. I want to do gaming. Gaming things like coaching. I mean, not like coaching, but the just like, you know, as you say, maybe providing something to young players, Korea or even like, you know, some other countries. That is kind of one of the meaningful things I can do, probably. Yeah. I hear a lot from many friends or many Tekken players that. They are just like, hey JD, focus. And that's it. That's best advice, I think. 425, wondering quick. Musician. Musician.
Would you like to sing or play some instruments?
No, I don't want to sing. I want to create. I want to create. I want
write
to.
Write music?
Yeah. But the. Because I really like, how would I say, like OST or something like that? Movie OST, gaming OST. I really like gaming OST. And then I like something that I like, I wanna create something that I can tell my story with, you know? Like hip hop, for example, they say they tell story, right? With their music. And then, let's say movie or video or maybe
a book
or game. They play, but also they hear the music and they get inspired, right? Yeah, I wanna be a musician. Yeah, I mean musician? No, producer. Yeah, producer. Yeah. Thank you for watching my interview, and then always appreciate for your support. 항상 응원, 네, 감사합니다. 항상 열심히 하는 모습을 최선을 다해 유지하겠습니다. 감사합니다.